Hello, good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, sir.
Where are the kids? Oh, that is.
Hello, ma'am.
Yeah, Muneeb is around here.
Good morning.
Oh, is it a rain holiday for everybody? Muneeb, where are your friends?
I don't know.
Okay, we'll give ourselves a couple of minutes. They should be here. In my class, I'll remind them. Yeah, they should be here. Anyway. Comes to you.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, Safia.
Good morning.
So who have joined? Just see your textbook. Have you completed your homework? But I gave
yes,
you
ma'am. I did the circuits.
Circuits
the circuit thing, right?
Three circuits you asked, no? I did that.
Yeah.
I also did.
Page number 90 and 91, sure?
Yes, ma'am. Wait. I'm sure. Am I send the picture of the circuit, no?
Ah, you send the picture now. It's not, just lift it a little up.
Yes.
For me.
No, I'm doing something. Yes. Now you will understand. I will do.
Okay, top circuit, one battery and a bulb. Then, okay. You don't have to do this cut, okay?
Well, okay.
Okay. So parallel battery you have connected. Muneeb, you need to connect the batteries in series only. Okay. The plus na together you have connected in the B diagram. Okay. Make okay. It plus minus only. In the sequence you connect the battery.
Okay.
Okay.
In one wire only.
In that wire only you connect. And negative co you connect it to the positive. Don't connect the negative to negative. Okay. In all the diagrams you have done like that only. So just rub it and make plus go negative say. Okay?
Yes, yes.
I'll show you.
Ma'am.
It's not clear. Yes. Yes, that is correct. First one is correct. So show me the second one.
Wait, huh?
Yes, Safia, it is correct. See, Muneeb, I was telling this way only. Huh? Plus to minus.
Yes. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So two batteries in the same line you have to connect. Fine?
Yes. Yes, ma'am.
I did four diagrams like that.
Yeah. And then today your homework is page number 90 and 91. All the circuit diagrams. Okay? Just you have to see what corrections, what is wrong, Aisha. Fan on.
Ma'am, page number 91.
Page 90 and 91. There are circuits are given and they have asked you what are the mistakes over there. So you have to do that. First question is, so you
just have to complete it and send.
Yes, complete this and send. Okay. Because all are circuit diagrams only. Okay, everyone has joined. And switch on your cameras, all of you. What happened today? You are late. Today I was the first person to join. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Who is left still? Let them join. We'll start. Farhana, Abdullah, are you there? Okay, last homework was? From the textbook, I gave you the answers and you had to complete till 89, right?
Yes.
page number 90 and 91, and then 92 and 93. These are just review questions. So complete these four pages. Simple diagram questions are there. Can you see in your textbook? 90, 91, 92, 93. Send me the pictures on Google Classroom. Okay. Abdullah, did you get the pics from Mirza Mudammil?
Yes.
Okay. So complete it and send it on Google Classroom.
Can you repeat the pages?
Page number is 90, 91, 92, 93. The mistakes are there in the circuit diagram. What mistakes are there? You have to correct. Okay. And click the picture and send it to me on Google Classroom. Okay. Fine. Any doubt is there till page 89? Any question, any doubt in solving, in finding the answers of the questions? Anyone has doubt? Who said yes? Anyone has doubt? No, na? Everyone is quiet. That means it is no. Everything is clear. Okay. So we'll just do a small recap. We did some formula. We have been doing some formula for in electricity, the basic formula. So what are the formula that we did in the last class? I'm just sharing.
V, E.
Can you write down for Hana?
I was saying, ma'am. I was saying.
Okay. You were saying? Can you write down? Me. Can you write down here? Or should I write? You tell me.
You write. Fine, I'll try writing.
Okay. You tell me. What is the first formula that we did?
Should I write or not?
I'm writing. You tell me. What is the first formula we did?
I, ma'am.
I. So, I is, what is I? I is equal to?
Q upon T.
I is equal to Q upon T. What is Q, Farhana? What is Q?
Total. What?
Q is the net charge.
I don't have lights.
Yes, Q is the net charge. So in terms of electron charge, how will you write?
Ne.
Ne. So N is the number of electron. And what is E? E is the?
Electron.
Electron.
E is not electron. E is charge on electron. Okay?
My total number.
Yes. Amina, what is E? N is total number. N is total number. Total number of electrons. Okay.
E is electron, right? Energy. Yes.
And E is, small e is charge on one electron.
Yeah.
Charge on, so this should be.
And the bigger E is energy, right?
Bigger E is energy. Okay. So Q is equal to N into E. So E is fixed. What is E key value? E is
0.6 into 10 minus 19.
Coulomb. Coulomb you have to say.
Yeah. Okay.
So you always keep it here. I is current. I is current. Okay. Q is net charge.
Net charge is number of shell.
Net charge is total number of electrons into charge on one
electron.
Okay. And T is time. So this thing should be clear to you. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, what is the next formula? What is the next formula we did, Abdullah? This was the current formula, okay? Now, what next we did?
Voltage.
Our voltage is the third formula. Second formula was also there. Every time I revise this, huh? What is the
second?
Potential something.
FE is equal to KQ1.
Q1 is one charge. KQ1, Q2 upon R square. Where Q1 is charge on first electron.
Q2 would be charge on second electron.
Charge on first charge, you can say. First charge. And Q2 is charge on
second electron.
Second electron, nahi. Charge on second, matlab second object. Okay? Charge on second object. So, R and R, what is R? What is
R? R is equal to...
R is distance between two charges.
Q1
and Q2. Okay. Q1 and Q2 के बीच का distance है. So if this is Q1 and this is Q2, distance between them is R. Then force between them is given by Fe, which is equal to K Q1 Q2 by R square. Okay. This is one equation. This is one equation. Okay. So this was first one. This was second one and third one. Third one, who will tell me?
Ma'am, voltage.
Voltage.
Yes, correct. So what is voltage?
V is equal to voltage.
V is equal to what? Voltage, correct. What is the formula? You need to revise it before the class. Always revise what we did in the previous class. So what is V?
What does K stand for?
K is a constant. I told you, force is directly proportional. So K is a proportionality constant and its value is fixed. Okay. Its value is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught that you don't require right now. 9 into 10 raised to power 9. Okay, we don't need it right now because we are not doing numericals on this. Okay. V is equal to how much? Tell me. Anyone remember? Moansa, Mudabir, Farhana, Amina. Do you remember what is it?
No, ma'am.
It is work done.
Work done upon total number, I guess.
Total charge. Work done in bringing a positive charge from infinity to a particular point. So V is potential or potential difference. I'm writing it into short form. V is potential difference. W is work done or energy. Okay? Mm-hmm. And Q is the charge.
Is it clear? V is what, ma'am?
V is potential or potential difference. You remember I told you? Voltage is
potential. Like in here we have 1.6 into 10 minus 19 coulomb. Over here, what is the
potential difference, or you can say potential? Okay. Yes. What's up here? What are you asking?
In how do we find E is equal to that? You said 1.6 into 10 minus 19 degree coulomb. So how do we find voltage? That
voltage, work done is given and charge is given. How much charge is there?
How do we find
charge of one electron? But not necessarily that only always one electron will be there. Suppose I have a charge object and it has a charge of 24 coulomb. So here Q is equal to 24 coulomb. Okay. But charge on one electron is fixed. If you charge two objects by rubbing, one will get some charge. Suppose I'm rubbing two objects. And I told you in static electricity, when you are rubbing, charging by friction. So one object gets a positive charge and the other object which you are rubbing will get an equal amount of negative charge. Why? Because electron get transferred from here to here. So it has got same amount of positive charge and this will have same amount of negative charge. It depends on how many electrons are transferred from here to here. Because electron is negative, so when it moves away from an object, that object will become positively charged. And on the object where it comes, that object becomes negatively charged. Okay? So this was happening in static electricity. So equal amount of positive and negative charge. It is not that always one electron is there. You don't know how many electrons are there. Okay, so charge can be anything. I have written 24 coulomb positive charge. Same minus 24 coulomb can be negative charge also. Okay, so charge value in this formula, you have three. All of you have written these three formula. All of you have this formula. So always remember these three formula. One more formula I'll teach you. That is resistance. And that is a very important base of electricity. That is Ohm's law. Okay. So today, let us see if we get time, we'll do this. Okay, I'm stopping it. Let me see. Everyone has joined?
Yes. No, ma'am. One person is left.
Who is still left?
Don't know.
Okay, Ahmad, Switch on your camera. Saklane?
No, ma'am. Everyone is there.
No, I think Humaira is not there.
Yeah.
Okay, everyone switch on your camera. Ahmad, why you always keep it off? Because when I don't see you, I feel that you are not there in the class and I'm not able to ask questions also. Okay, so moving on. Today, we have revised what formula we did. No doubt in all the three formula. Okay.
Yes.
Ahmad, this was your question. What does K stand for? You got the answer. I gave the answer. K is constant of proportionality and its value is fixed. Okay, that you will have to learn. It is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught. Now, you don't know what is epsilon naught. So, that is why I'm not giving you. Okay, that is grade 11th ka topic. Epsilon naught is permittivity of the video. Okay, Saklane, no problem. If you have any doubt, please raise hand or you can ask question. Okay, fine. Now, we are beginning with our topic of today. And all of you, I gave you homework, whatever exercise is left in textbook that you have to complete, okay? So complete the exercise and send it to me on Google Classroom so that I can check it. If you are not sending me, I won't be able to check what mistake you are doing, okay? So the question today about the circuit is, first question, these are all circuit questions I have brought. So can you see the circuit over here? How many bulbs are there in this circuit? How many bulbs
four.
Are in this circuit? One,
like four.
Muneeb, tell
five.
Me. How many
no,
bulbs?
Five.
How many bulbs are there in this circuit?
When the cross in the circle stands for bulb, no?
Yes.
When the
five.
So there are five bulbs. Okay. Amina? How many bulbs are lit? Now you should know what is open switch and closed switch. Okay. So just see, is there a complete path happening over here?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
So how many bulbs will be lit?
None.
So zero will be the answer. Okay. Everyone, please mute yourself. Okay. Third one, Farhana. Switch X closes. Which bulbs will come on?
A.
If the switch
A and B. A and B.
If the switch X is closed, so current comes from here and it completes like this. So only A and B will be on. Okay. Okay. Ahmad, switch X closed. Ammeter 1 reads 1 ampere. What will ammeter 2 read? Switch X is closed, okay? So ammeter 1 is this and ammeter 2 is this, okay? 1 is not written over here. So switch X is closed. If ammeter 2 reads, ammeter 1 reads 1 ampere, what will ammeter 2 read?
I don't know.
You can try. Yeah, Muneeb, can you answer?
2 amperes on because both the bulbs are near to it.
Yeah.
No, it's not clear. What are you saying?
Ma'am, 2 amperes because both bulbs are near
two
to
bulbs
the...
bulbs are there, but see the path is same. Okay? Muazzam, Mudabbir, can you try?
Ma'am, 1 ampere.
Yes, 1 ampere because when the bulbs are in series, current remains same. I told you, remember? When bulbs are in series, current will be same now. Whatever current is coming over here, same current will go like this because there isn't a closed circuit over here. So no current is going over here. So whatever comes from here to one ammeter will go to the second ammeter also. So same current follows one path, so one current, same current.
So 1.0 is the answer, right?
Yes, 1.0 is the answer, okay? Okay, Abhuna, switch X and Y closed.
Which bulb will come on?
Which bulbs will be on?
All.
So you see for circuit, where is it completing? You have to see that. Switch X and Y are closed. So current will go. How will the current travel?
CD.
Who told me the answer?
Mudabbir.
Yeah, tell me, Mudabbir. Which bulbs? Name the bulbs.
A, B.
A and B, ma'am.
When? Y is also closed, na?
CD also, ma'am.
Yes,
CD also.
A, B, C, D. The current goes like this, comes here, branches off, one branch comes here because this is closed, and then they join together and go back here. So the current is moving through all these bulbs, A, B, C, and D. There won't be any current in C because this is open. Okay, so the answer is A, B, C, and D, the D option. Okay, this one. Bosom, you try. X and Y closed. Ammeter 2 is 1 ampere and ammeter 3 is 0.5 ampere. Ammeter 2 is 1 ampere and ammeter 3 is 0.5. What will ammeter 1 read? You know that current will come like this, branch out.
1.5 ampere.
Yes, correct. Very good. The current in this ampere is 1.5 because the whole current comes here. It gets divided into two parts, okay? So one part goes in ampere 2. Ampere 2, they have given 1 ampere. And one part goes in ampere 3, which is 0.5 ampere. So if you join together, the total current is 1 ampere, 1.5 ampere in this ammeter, first ammeter. Is it clear? Is there any doubt? You don't say yes or no also. How will I understand?
No. And the last one, I didn't understand.
Okay. See, X and Y are closed. The current comes from this. This is only one battery. So current will come from here. Plus se aata hai. Current will come from here. At this point, it will divide. The current will divide, right? So the total current is here. It gets divided into two parts. And they have given ammeter 2 has got 1 ampere. And ammeter 3 has got 0.5 ampere. That means if you join together, it goes in this ampere, right? Because the main current is this. This is divided into two parts. So this plus this should be this. So how much is this? 0.5 and 1.
1.5.
So 1.5 is the answer because the main current is this, which is coming from the battery. And at this point, it is getting divided because the current has got two paths now. These two bulbs are in parallel. This bulb and these two bulbs are in parallel. So it is getting divided. Current is getting divided. And divided means how much? This plus this will be this. In series, current is always same. In parallel, current gets divided. Okay? So the answer is 1.5. Okay, switch X and Z closed. Which bulbs will come on? Ahmed, you try now. Switch X and Z is closed. First one and the last one is closed. So which bulb will be on now?
A and B.
A and B only because there is no path, return path from here. In Z also it will not go. Okay. So only A and B will be glowing. So these were the circuit. Now today, coming to our topic, resistance. I have already told earlier also, resistance, which slows down the current. Okay. So it opposes the current. It is a property of a conductor which resists the flow. So that is why resistance. So resist the flow of electric current through it. You have seen this is a type of resistance. You can see the color coding over here. These color coding gives you the value of resistance. What value of resistance is there? Okay. Unit of resistance is ohm. And how do we write resistance? Resistance, we write it as ohm is written as like this. Okay. This is called as omega. This is a Greek alphabet. So omega, we don't write it OHM. We write it as this. If I want to say that, see, you can see over here 30 ohm, 20 ohm. So this is a sign of ohm. You don't need to write it as OHM. Okay. Because you have a short form, which is omega. Okay. So omega means ohm and it is written as, it is the unit of ohm. It is the unit of resistance. So SI unit of resistance is ohm. You can see two circuits over here. Have you done this type of circuit? What type of circuit is this? Series or parallel? First one. First one, Abdullah, is it a series circuit or a parallel circuit?
I think it's a parallel one, right?
Yes, it is a parallel circuit. Farhana, which type of circuit is this? The second one?
It's a series circuit.
Yes, it is a series circuit. So you observe, see, in series circuit, what happens? Current from this battery will go and same current passes through all the resistances and comes back. Okay, but here in parallel circuit, current from this battery comes here and at this junction, it divides it into two parts and then again join back and the total current goes back to the battery. Okay, so remember that in series connection, current in all the resistance remains same. And in parallel connection, current gets divided into the branches of resistors. Okay, in series, current remains same. In parallel, potential remains same. Okay, that means potential across R1 and across R2 is same, which is equal to ES only. Is it clear? So these are the two major difference in series and parallel resistance. Now, what is resistance and how it comes into existence, we'll do now. You can see this picture over here. Okay. This is, you suppose that these person going through this pipe is normal current, and because of the voltage, they are getting the push. Voltage means they are getting the push to go. Somebody has pushed. The last person has pushed this cue and they are moving like this. But suddenly this person he puts a hindrance over here in the pipe, and then the flow means the person's moving through this pipe, they will find some difficulty in moving, crossing this pipe over this side. Okay. So this person is acting as a resistance. These persons going in this direction is current. And the push by which they are going is voltage. Okay. Now what happens? The same thing happens in electrons over here. You can see the second picture over here. See, the current moves like this when the resistance is less. When the resistance is increased, you see there is a hindrance in the flow of current. And that is why the current slows down. You can see over here the resistance. It tries to stop the current, or it slows down the current. Okay, so these are just the picture to understand how the current is slowed down by resistance. Okay, do you understand this picture? The same thing, analogous thing comes in the resistance part. Now actually what happens, these are the type of resistance you see in labs. We use these types. All of them are resistances only, and these are fixed resistances. Okay, remember I showed you variable resistance that day, rheostat. When you move, you remember, and Saklin was showing it. So that was variable resistance, and these are fixed resistance. In the circuit, we draw resistance like this. Okay, the hindrance to the current is resistance, and resistors are the circuit elements that regulate current flow. So these are resistors, okay, that offer resistance. Yeah.
If we don't put a resistor in the circuit, then?
I'm coming to that. If you don't put a resistor in the circuit, you know friction, how friction is important, same way resistance is important for the current. If there is no resistance, a very high current will flow, and a very high current leads to heat. Heat leads to fire. So it can burn the appliance, whatever appliance
is. And resistance can save fire.
Resistance are there to oppose current, to slow down current. So if very high current is there in the circuit, it can leak, it can damage the appliances. Whatever appliances connect, whatever appliance that current is flowing, okay, if there isn't any resistance, it can damage the appliance. Okay, so not only fire, it can damage also. Okay, so resistors are there to protect the appliances. Okay, now I'll show you how it protects. Now see, these are electrons, minus minus sign, can you see? And this is a way to show that the resistance offer the hindrance, but actually actually the conductor does not shrink like this. Okay, actually what happens is that I'll show you in the next diagram. These are the flow of electrons going like this, but actually the conductor does not shrink. What happens is, see what happens, these are metal ions and these are the blue color are electrons. Okay, remember in the previous classes I have told you that these are the free electrons which are responsible for flow of current. Why? If this is plus terminal and this is negative terminal, what will happen? These electrons will start moving towards the positive terminal, right? In an ordered way. Now, when they are moving from this side to this side, what will happen? Because so many ions are there, the ions from which these electrons have come out, okay? So these ions, they are stationary, but the electrons are moving. What happens when too many people are standing stationary or too many pillars are there in the room and you are 10, 15 people are running in the room? What will happen? Tell me, Abdullah, what will happen if you are running in the room and 10, 15 pillars are standing stationary in the room? What will happen?
It will be harder.
It will be harder. And you will be, there will be probability of colliding with the pillars. Is it clear? Colliding means, I have told you,
hitting the pillars.
Colliding means hitting, right? So there is probability of hitting the electrons with these ions. So whenever these electrons are attracted towards the positive terminal and they start moving towards the positive terminal, but in the way, you can see so many stationary ions are there, the ions from which the electrons have only come out, okay? So they will start running, means they will accelerate, they will start towards positive terminal, but in the way they will collide or they will hit these ions and the velocity will decrease, means they will, the speed will decrease, again they will start moving, again they will collide. So these collisions are responsible for the resistance, okay? When you hit somebody, when you hit the pillar, what happens? Your speed decreases, right? Then you again start running, again you are hit by another pillar, then again your velocity decreases, your speed decreases, again you start moving faster, again something collides. So this goes on. So these collisions decreases your, slows down the current, slows down the speed of electrons.
You mean this is a metal ions or the resistance?
The collisions are the cause of resistance. Understood? More the number of collisions. Collisions means we say in Hindi mein takkar bolte. Understand? Understood this? So, jitne zyada collisions honge, utna zyada resistance hoga. So, more the number of collisions, more will be the resistance. Is it clear? And you know that conductor may, you have these ions, stationary ions, because electrons have come out from these ions only. Is it clear? So, I'll explain you once again. You have a conductor and conductor has got free electrons. You know that why? Current flows easily through the conductor because of the presence of free electrons. And what are free electrons? Free electrons are the outermost shell electrons which have come out of the atom in the conductor. So these are now ions. So these are stationary, but the electrons, when they get a positive, when you connect this conductor with a positive terminal and a negative terminal of a battery, these electrons being negatively charged will get attracted towards the positive terminal of the battery, but they will start moving. When you get attracted, you will move with a very high speed. So these electrons start moving with a very high speed, but there are certain ions present in between which are stationary and they start colliding. So jabhi bhi collision hoga, the velocity decreases, the speed of the electron decreases. But because of this positive attraction, it will again start moving, but again it will collide, again the speed goes down, again it collides. So this process goes on. So these collisions actually slow down the speed of electrons. And you know that movement of electron is current, right? Only thing is it is in the opposite direction. Is it clear, Farhana? Is it clear? Who will explain me in your own words what you have understood? Muazzam, can you explain me what you have understood?
Ma'am, that the electrons move at a very fast speed to the.
Why they move at very fast speed? You tell me. Before that, you tell me why the electrons move at very high speed.
Ma'am, they are attracted to the positive terminals. Something attracts them. So, so they move towards a positive terminal, and in between they collide, which slows down their speed.
They then collide with. You have to clarify. They collide with the immobile ions.
They collide with the immobile ions. Their speed decreases. Then again, they get because of the attraction, they start moving, and this process keeps on repeating itself.
Yeah, and keep on colliding with the immobile ions. So the cause of resistance is the collision of electrons. What is the cause of resistance?
I have a question, ma'am.
Yeah. Tell me.
Do the electrons like move in a straight line or?
Electrons are moving in a straight line. Normally, they are moving randomly, okay, when there is no battery connection. But when there is a battery connection, they will start in moving in a straight line, means ordered way they start moving, because they are moving in a one direction. They'll move in one direction only. Electron will move towards a positive terminal only. Okay, so that is why a straight line motion over. But the presence of immobile ions will decrease their speed, and this collision give rise to resistance. So that is why we say resistance means which resists the flow of current. Okay, fine. Is it clear, Amina?
Yes, ma'am.
Is there any doubt, Ahmad? Is there any doubt, Safiya?
Yes, I have a question.
Yes, Ahmad.
I heard that electricity moves at the speed of light.
Electricity moves with the speed of light. Electricity moves, but the electron moves very slowly. Electricity moves, that is electromagnetic. See, there are so many number of electrons, but the electron does not move with the speed of light. Electron moves very slow. As you see here, you can see over here, electrons are moving very fast, and because of the positive charge, they get accelerated also. But because of the resistance, their speed decreases. So that is why we say electrons are drifting. Drift meaning you understand what is the meaning of drift? Do you understand in English?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
They are moving very slow. So electrons are moving very slowly in the conductor when the conductor is connected with a negative and positive charge. So we cannot say that, but current will move very fast. Okay? Because there are number of electrons moving together, they will move fast, but electrons are moving very slow because of the collisions happening over here, or because of the resistance, you can say. Okay? Is it clear?
Okay.
You cannot say that electron is moving very fast when there is no battery connection. Very fast. But when there is a battery connection, because they are moving in an ordered way, because of these collisions, what happens? The current is slowed down, resistance, because of the presence of resistance, electrons, we say, are drifting. Electrons drift towards it. Okay? Is he or she, your brother or sister, Ahmed?
He's my brother.
Brother, okay. He'll be an expert in electricity now, huh? How old is he?
He's two.
2 years old. Okay, great. So it is clear, everyone? Drift velocity. Electron is drifting. Electron is not accelerating because of the presence of, because of the presence of immobile ions, electrons collide. And this give rise to resistance. And because of this, current slows down. So that is why we say resistance is offering or slowing down the flow of current. Okay. You can see over here now. Yes, Amina, you asked what will happen if there is no resistance in the circuit. See, there is a resistance in the circuit. It reduces the flow of current and your bulb glows properly. But if there is no resistance, very high current from the battery flows to the bulb and it damages the bulb. Okay, so too much of current, it will blow out this. Is it clear? So resistors are important for the circuit because it reduces the flow of current. It prevents a very high current to the battery, to the appliance, whatever appliance is there. Here it is a bulb, it can be anything. Okay, is it clear, Amina? Can you see the circuit? These two circuits, the difference. Here it is a resistance, here there is no resistance. See, one more circuit. Now you can see these balls. These balls are like electrons, okay? And this battery is providing the push. All of you know that battery provides the push to the electrons, okay? So because of the battery only, the electron get attracted towards the positive terminal and the current flows, okay? So here you see that this force, the battery is pushing the electrons and it goes like this, but here there is a resistance. Because of the resistance, the voltage drops here and this is a flow of current taking place like this. So resistance has got a voltage drop also. So voltage, total voltage is here and here the voltage gets decreased because of the presence of resistance. Means it eats the voltage also. The resistor eats the voltage also. Is it clear? And here you get a lesser voltage. Now how it happens, it is given by the Ohm's law, which we'll understand. Is it clear? The diagram is clear to you all. This way the electron flow take place, yes. And this way the current flows. Okay. Here you can see the resistor is present over here. Here it is a battery which gives the push to the electrons and it is going like this. Here, because of the resistance, see, the speed slows down. The speed of electrons slows down over here. Okay, inside the conductor. But in the wire, it is going fine. So resistor opposes the current, it slows down the current, you can say. Okay, so now what are the factors which affect resistance? So I'll just write down over here so that you remember. There is a formula. If you remember this formula, it will be easier for you to learn. Resistance is, first one, resistance start over here. Let me wait. Now what happens? What factors influence resistance? Conductivity of the material, okay? If an object is an insulator, it does not have any electrons, right? Free electrons. So it will have very high resistance. Rubber has more resistance than copper. So insulator will not offer will not allow current to flow through them. So insulators will have very high resistance. So it depends on conductivity. Insulators will have very high resistance. Length of the material. Now how it depends on length of the material, you know that. Pen is drawing something different. Wait. Okay. What factors affect influence? So I'll write it over here. Now what happens? You know that longer is the length. If the length of the conductor is very long, what will happen? You will have more number of electrons and more number of collisions, right? You will have longer is the length, more number of electrons and more number of collisions. So resistance will, what will happen to resistance? Tell me, if the length of the wire is long, there will be more number of electrons and there will be more number of collisions. Abdullah, you tell me, what will happen to resistance? Tell me, you know what is resistance, na? You know what is resistance?
Yes.
Resistance happens because of the collision, okay? So if the wire is long, so more collision will take place. So resistance will be more or less?
It will be more.
It will be more. So you will
see, because resistance is something which blocks the current from flowing.
Yeah, which slows down the current. So collisions actually slows down the electron motion, right? So resistance, I will say, is directly proportional to L. Means length of the conductor. More is the length of the conductor, resistance will be more, Okay, so directly, you remember I told you directly proportional means one quantity increases, other also increases. Now what happens to if your wire is thicker? If your wire is suppose thicker, this is the thickness of the wire. What happens if the wire is thicker? More number of electrons will come out of the wire, right? More number of electrons will come out. If more number of electrons are coming out, that means resistance is what? Less. Correct? See, resistance is, so you can see that resistance is inversely proportional to area of cross-section. Area of cross-section, I told you it is thickness. So you just remember resistance is directly proportional to length. That means more is the length, more will be the resistance. And if the thickness is more, resistance is less. Why? Because thicker wire, you remember I gave you in the last exercise, we were doing question that if the wire is thick, what will happen to the brightness of the bulb? So if the wire is thick, resistance of the wire will be less and the bulb will lit brighter. Okay, so these are the two equations. R is directly proportional to L, means longer is the length, resistance is more, and more is the area, more is the thickness, resistance will be less. It is inversely proportional. Okay, inversely means one quantity increases, one decreases. Okay, so if I write like this, and one more thing, temperature is more. What will happen to collisions if temperature is more? Mohsen, you tell. What will happen to what will happen to the collision of electron and ions if the temperature is increased? Temperature of the conductor. If you increase, what will happen?
Ma'am, can I answer?
Ma'am, it will be more.
Resistance will be more. Why? Because collisions will be more. Yeah, Abdullah, you tell me what you were telling.
I was telling the same thing, ma'am.
So if temperature increases, their speed increases, the velocity of electron increases, and because of that, they will collide more, and then the resistance increases. So there are three factors on which it depends. Resistance depends on length of the conductor. More is the resistance, more will be the length, more will be the resistance. Resistance depends on the thickness of the wire. More is the thickness, lesser is the resistance. And more is the temperature, more will be the resistance. So you have three relationships. Can somebody give me a gist of these three relationships? Who will give me? Farhana, can you give me the relationship of resistance, dependence of resistance on length, thickness and temperature? Farhana, are you there? Okay. Who will tell? Safiya, can you tell me? It is there on the screen.
Yes, ma'am. Resistance in length will be more.
Yeah. No, length. If length is more, resistance will be more. Okay, like that you have to say. If length is less, resistance will be less. Now tell me about this. Thickness.
Thickness will have less resistance.
Thickness is more, resistance will be less. Okay. And if temperature is more, what happens to resistance?
More resistance.
Yeah. So these are the three things. Now, next class, I'm going to revise this. But remember the three points: resistance dependence on length, resistance dependence on thickness, and resistance dependence on temperature. Okay. And what is the cause of resistance? Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Any doubt is there till here? Any doubt?
No, ma'am.
Okay. Just revise and then we'll discuss it in the next class. Okay? Fine. Bye and see you in the maths class.